All right, in this episode, we're gonna cover our Sennheiser Wireless G3 Lavalier microphones. Now, what I've learned is that the G3 wireless system has to deal with the packs that are used to do the wireless transmission. And then the lavalier microphone is a separate microphone. We're using, I believe, the ME-2 omnidirectional microphone. And let me tell you a little bit about how we got these. When I started doing videography and I started ByteSite, I was doing a lot of work with LSpark, who is one of our big clients. And I was talking to the managing director there, Pat White, who recommended that I get a good microphone because we're gonna do a lot of interviews and we're gonna do a lot of event coverage. So I went out and purchased these microphones, and it's been one of the best purchases we've ever made for sure. So we mainly use these for interviews. We do a lot of interviews, we do a lot of talking head, and we wire up the microphone just like this. And it's a really great way to get good audio. The other place we actually use it is event coverage, which is really great. So we either put the microphone on the talent, okay, and then we can get great audio for that. And because these are wireless, they can walk around and we get great audio for that. Or the other thing we do with them is we actually hook them up to the soundboard and run the audio to our camera, which is really, really nice. Now we are using the lavs on these videos, and you might be thinking, oh, it's pretty good audio, but there's a lot of echo. Lavaliers don't solve echo problems, and this microphone especially is an omnidirectional microphone, so it's gonna pick up a lot of that. And we just happen to be in an echoey space, so we definitely apologize for that. All right, our setup is very simple. We put our microphone on our talent, or we ask them to put it on, we hook it up to the transmitter. Then we have a receiver that's sitting on a cold shoe mount on the camera, and we run the output from that receiver into our Zoom H4n recorder. You can also check out our H4n video to see how the chain goes past that. Now, another setup that we use that's kind of interesting that we kind of came up on the fly was actually getting the audio from a soundboard. So sometimes we do event coverage and there are sound mixers there who are running a mixing board and they'll give us a feed. So we'll run that feed into the Zoom H4n, and out of the H4n, we'll actually send the signal to this, to the transmitter. And then we put the receiver on our camera, and what's great about that is we get wireless audio to our camera from the soundboard. So that's another setup that we actually do that's proven to work really well. And lastly, when we're kind of doing maybe smaller productions or quicker turnaround times, sometimes we run the receiver directly into the camera. So what do we like about the system? Well, first of all, if you want your videos to start being more professional or have a higher quality, invest in sound. Sound is a really big differentiator between what makes a professional video and what's not a professional video. I mean, cameras these days on phones are super good, and anybody can shoot a really, really nice video, but not a lot of people pay attention to sound. So the first thing I really love about the system is we're getting great professional sound, even if our subject is really far away. We're getting really nice audio and really brings that professional quality to our videos. Second thing I have to mention is the range is nuts. I haven't done an official test. I've heard people like going a kilometer away and still getting good audio. Like, the range on these wireless packs are really, really good. So when we're doing event coverage, sometimes we're at the far back of the room, you know, at the back of 200 people sitting in a room, and we'll still get great audio because the range on this is really good and it's really clear. Battery life is great. The receiver and the transmitter both run on AA batteries, and they'll probably last about 2 hours or a little bit longer than that, which is really, really nice. I've had nothing to say but good things about the sound. I mean, I'm not an audiophile, I'm not a professional sound mixer, but the sound that's coming out of these seems really clean and really nice, and the microphone that comes with it seems to be really, really good as well. Like I mentioned, we discovered this new way to use this wireless system, and that's the great thing about this system. Just the fact that you have that wireless system opens up a lot of possibilities for sure. And lastly, what's really great about this is the kit comes with a lot of accessories and a lot of cables. So they come with mounting points, so they come with a cold shoe adapter, they come with an XLR cable, they come with a 3.5 millimeter cable, you know, they come with the microphone and the microphone clip and a little tiny windscreen. So they come with a lot of little accessories, which is really great. I always love when you're buying camera gear and they throw in a whole bunch of free stuff with it as well. All right, so what don't we like about the system? Well, first of all, it definitely starts to get into the pricier range of products. So the Sennheiser wireless system in Canada costs about $730. And that's basically for one microphone. So if you want to get two microphones because you're doing two interviews, you're talking $1,400 for these microphones, you know? And here's the thing, you're not really paying that much for the microphone. If you're paying for the microphone itself, I think it's only about 50 bucks. What you're really paying for is this robust wireless transmission system. These things are built very strong, they have really good range, and that's what you're paying for. But for sure, it is definitely on the pricier side. And then the second thing I'll mention that is probably very good if you are a professional sound mixer, but can definitely get in the way if you're not a professional sound mixer, is just how many adjustments there are. And I'm talking purely about levels. So this is something we call gain structure. So what you set on your input and output in your gain structure, right? That can get very complicated because first of all, you can set the level on the transmitter. Then second, you can set the level of output on the receiver. Then you can set the input level on your recorder, like your Zoom, right? So you have three places where you're adjusting levels, and to get optimal sound, that's not immediately obvious. Sometimes a quick plug and play system will do a lot better. Another thing that we should mention that you should be concerned about is interference. This is a wireless system, and you have potential for other devices to interfere with the wireless signal. Now, we actually experienced this on a shoot. We didn't do a proper location survey, and when we got there, we realized that we couldn't use the wireless lavs because there was interference. So that's definitely something to watch out for. And in fact, Sennheiser sells multiple versions of this wireless system, and it all has to do with the frequencies that they play in. So you can get this wireless G3 kit, and I believe they're designated like A, B, or C, and they all have to do with the different set of frequencies that you can play around with. So definitely an issue to be concerned about, definitely something to watch out for when considering buying a wireless system. All right, so in summary, we love the wireless G3 system. We've been using it for 5 or 6 years now. Just so you know, that Sennheiser has come out with the successor called the G4, so that might be something worth checking out. But as a result, the G3s are probably going on sale, and I think the G3s, there's nothing wrong with them. Definitely check them out. If you're seriously considering good audio, purchase this. You will not regret it at all. If you have any questions at all about how we use this gear or the gear itself, leave them in the comments below. And don't forget to subscribe to our channel. All right, that's it, guys. We'll see you in the next one. I'm chilling.